Who doesn't love a good mural? They make you happy, they make you smile, and they make you excited. So this is our Fox 4 mural map, so you can see as many of the murals in Kansas City as possible. If you follow us on Instagram, you've probably already seen some of them on our Insta story. And as you continue to explore all of Kansas City street art, the people behind the paintbrushes want you to know that their work is more than just a pretty picture.
On to Kansas City.
Kansas City, home of the Chiefs, the Royals, and
a lot of murals.
You've probably seen the one behind the burger place.
Brandon Baker keeps his lens open to document as many murals and artists as he can.
You have Scribe, you have Psyche, you have Jason, who riffraff. There's just so much of a variety of talent.
He shares all his pictures on the Graffiti KC Instagram.
My goal is to, you know, bring more awareness to the artists and help people explore the city more.
Baker is also a coordinator for Spray Simo, an annual mural festival. Artists come from all over to add their street art to Kansas City's blank canvases. And Baker is there for it all, snapping away.
For people buying buildings, the murals, they're not gonna last forever. So for me, I think it's important to document the murals for, you know, future generations that grow up in Kansas City, or people that don't even live in Kansas City and wanna get to know more about the art scene we have here.
And that art scene is pretty big. There's Art Alley.
You go in there with a can of spray paint and throw a piece up.
And murals painted by artists who make a living from their work.
I've lived in other cities, and I just don't think that you would have the opportunity that you do here.
Steve Bohall has murals all over the metro. His latest is at the new J. Rieger Distillery in the East Bottoms.
This is really cool because this is from way back in the day when J. Rieger was selling before they were closed down due to Prohibition. This is the old monogram logo.
Bohall painted out his niche just like other Kansas City artists, known for their unique styles.
This is probably one of my favorites. I'm lactose intolerant, but I love the ice cream. My kids love it. And I feel like a lot of people love taking pictures in front of it and like being under there, the sprinkles kind of falling down.
The mural at Betty Ray's in the River Market is JT Daniels' creation. Fun fact, Daniels also designed the label for Brisk. Everything has a signature.
And I added in the words like yep and sup. So like sup is surviving under pressure, because I feel like everyone as humans is surviving under pressure at some point. And then yep is a very Midwestern thing. I learned that from my grandfather before he passed.
Some may be hidden, but all of Kansas City's murals have messages.
The zebra is a metaphor for myself as a biracial person, and so I like to show the zebra doing fun things as far as leading the pack of horses or being running free on a wall. And
the zebra,
it's grown legs and it's fat and happy running around.
Grace's Kansas City thanks to Phil Schaefer, who goes by Psych Style. He runs Psych Style Industries full time.
I employ a team of people that help me out on some projects such as the zebra here. And so shout out to Mike and Ben who helped me paint this.
Zebras and all sorts of creatures bring Kansas City together and create all sorts of actions, like uplifting an area.
It causes the public to kind of come outside and look and see what's going on. And one thing I always feel that artists, especially like artists that make public facing work, that we become placemakers.
And teaching people to follow their career goals and dreams.
Just thankful that I get to do what I love and take care of for a family. It's helped me grow up, taught me persistence and patience and how to deal with disappointment, and made me a better man.
And whatever the message, it's for all to enjoy.
Public art is a chance for people who don't know about art to at least enjoy it and engage it with it. And so the idea that it's a, I guess, a demonetized form of artwork. There's no entry fee to see a mural. You can just walk by and see it, and you don't need to feel like you're an elitist in a gallery or snooty in a museum. It's there for the public and for everybody.
Here's where you can go to check out the beautiful murals in the metro. We have this interactive map for you with locations and artist details on fox4kc.com. Follow us on Instagram at fox4kc. Watch our story on Fridays for new murals. You can also look back at the Mural Madness highlights on our account. And let us know where some of your favorite murals are so we can add them to our map. Alana LaFleur, Fox 4 News.